Alban Sanatorium, Radford, Virginia. Where pain and torment are experienced on a daily basis, ghosts are sure to dwell. And few places are as acutely stained with agony as old mental hospitals. That's because both their facilities and staff left much to be desired. In the 1900s, the mentally ill were basically lab rats for doctors who were more often eager to test out experimental procedures on them. As a result, the dead usually outnumbered the living in early sanatoriums. Those who weren't killed during some pilot medical trial usually just chose to off themselves. So depressing were hospital environments. Thus, many of these old mental institutions are rumored to be haunted. But only one has beaten out other types of paranormally busy sites, such as cemeteries and battlefields, to become known as the most active location on the East Coast. Alban Sanatorium. The hospital's haunted story begins before it was even built. During the 1700s, the city's close proximity to the New River watershed attracted Native Americans and early European settlers alike. Competition over the area resulted in hostilities between the two groups. In July 1755, a group of Shawnee Indians brought tensions to a climax. They attacked and looted the colonists of Draper's Meadow, killing at least 5 people and taking others as hostage. To survivors, the Shawnee left behind grisly reminders of their wrath. The Liberick couple too, for instance, was presented with a bag containing the decapitated head of Philip Barger. Mary Draper Ingalls was one of those held for ransom at the Shawnee town of Sononcio. Before she was taken prisoner, Mary first had to witness the gruesome deaths of her fellow colonists, including her mother and sister-in-law's baby. Elena Draper was tomahawked and scalped. Betty Draper's infant child was brained against the side of one of the cabins. Mary eventually managed to flee from Sononcio, but her journey back home was not an easy one. Some sources say that she was forced to abandon the baby she'd given birth to during her captivity.